No, thank you, Mr. Chairman. It's really around the comment that Mr. McIntosh made yesterday that he was going to present to the Corporate and Strategic Committee, which indicates he's having ongoing discussions with staff, otherwise that arrangement wouldn't have been made. So when will that committee meeting be held, Mr. Lambert?
There's two committee meetings left in this triennium. One is in early July, and the other one is on the, so about the 10th of July, I think, and the other one's on the 4th of September. So I offered to him, first of all, to come to the, for him to present to the one in July. He wasn't confident that he would have the final case prepared by then.
He wasn't
when I spoke to him about this last week, but he was more comfortable about coming to the September meeting of the committee.
Question, Councillor Gilbertson.
The question I ask is, why is this not just to carry forward like the other ones? Why is this not treated as a...
Well, it has been carried forward, but now we're making a determination on that submission.
Yes, but I can't see that this shouldn't be carried forward in the same way that we've carried other things.
Well, it has been to date, but now we've still got to make a decision on the submission. So, before I ask for a second, why September?
Just some date soon.
A date that's soon.
Okay, so the motion is you've added in there and a decision made by September?
End of September.
Okay, is there a seconder for that, Councillor Scott? Well, hang on, let's... It's about to happen. Yes.
With a decision made by September 30.
Decision to do what?
Well, presumably the money disappears at that stage, is that right?
Well, but the decision to be made by...
30 September. Yeah, well, it's more than just them. It includes...
This council will make a decision on...
We will have enough information for us to make a decision there, to expend or not to expend. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. So it's been moved and seconded.
Clarification?
Mm.
So we can decide on the 30th of September to continue the provision or not. That's the decision.
Or commit the funding to the actual project, I think is that the intention? Yeah.
Well, that to me reads that on the 30th of September we sit down and we say, right, we'll either cut it off or make a final decision.
Yeah, it could be.
Either or. So it doesn't say anything much, because we're delaying to make a decision.
No, you're not. Let's hear the debate, Councillor. Unless there's any other questions.
Yeah.
Let's have the debate.
Well, Mr. Chairman, this entire issue, which was debated at length this time last year, was intended to provide a tremendous opportunity for the development of hockey in the region, but it was premised on all the players in the hockey fraternity in Hawke's Bay agreeing on a plan. And what I'm seeing is transacted over that period of time is that there's been, I think, one cup of coffee with the protagonists involved. And to my way of thinking, that's totally unacceptable. And what it's demonstrating is that the bid in itself from both the Hastings District Council and from the Regional Sports Trust was a Clayton's bid. It never had the legs that was prescribed to it. It didn't have the support that it was intended to have. It certainly doesn't have the imprimatur of Hockey New Zealand in the way that was presented. So what we've got is a stalemate between the parties, and one where we were quite explicit in asking for the parties to get together, and they've simply refused to do that. And in my view, Mr. Chairman, that contemptuous behaviour from the players involved is totally unacceptable. My own view is that 30th of September is far too long. It should have been the 30th of June to say, look, either front up, put the proposal there, show that you've agreed, or, you know, get off the field because you're not playing. And so we're in this situation, Mr. Chair, of having a tremendous amount of resource, $2 million. There's no other sporting fraternity in Hawke's Bay has potentially in line for that sort of support. And we've got these turkeys mucking about for a whole year without any form of agreement to go forward. And because it's taken so long, they do not, in my mind, deserve the time of day for this council to be looking at an opportunity to fund to this level. I just think it's outrageous and we shouldn't actually be doing it at all.
Mr. Chairman, I look at the purpose that we set up the Regional Facilities Fund and the goalposts that we set for everyone to pass them. And all the projects that have been approved and are seriously progressing, either with their funding applications or with resource consent or with the buildings nearly finished, have met those particular criteria. We did have this one here with a lot of support, but it did not measure up to the criteria. And we gave them time to go away and bring that proposal to us to see how we could tie together a regional facility, albeit one with services in different areas, but a regional approach to providing for it. A year later, we are no further on with that, and I think there should be a time limit on completing that process. We've been told with this submission that they are almost there with a business case. So I think it's fair enough to, we've given them a bit more leniency and time to bring that to us. But we can't just keep running this on and on and on until you've got the proposal that stacks up, especially when it gets thrown at you at the last minute. We've got plan B for something totally different. This was a specific proposal. Either it flies or it doesn't fly. Either it is a regional facility or it's not a regional facility. And I think that by looking at a timeline at the end of September, it tidies it up to the end of this particular council term. And if it doesn't fly, so be it. If they come with a good case, it will fly.
Other speakers?
Clarification, Mr. Chairman. What will happen, what does their mover have in mind, what will happen to the $2 million if there's no decision made?
I envisage, Mr. Chairman, it goes back into the pool and some other more deserving scenario was put forward to council.
Question.
But then there's an option that it could be carried forward again.
Yes, that's right. It could be carried forward again. Do you wish to speak?
Another question. That would still be dedicated to a choice of the Hastings district?
No.
It's been a fund. It's there. Councillor Gilbertson.
The comment, Mr. Chairman, to call someone a techie because it's taken the whole year to make a decision is a bit rich coming from a councillor when Graham Hanson the other day said since 2002 we've been talking to Napier City Council about that piece of dirt by Guppy Road. So I think we just need slightly more rational debate. I believe this $2 million was promised to them. The fact it's taken the year, they can't agree. Carry forward. We just carried forward a whole lot of our internal expenditure. So there's a whiff of hypocrisy about this debate. We're all saying how terrible they are, and yet we've carried things on for 4 years. So I'd say get real.
Lunchtime pending. Any other speakers?
To have my pennies worth. I understand the angst around the table, and I'm also disappointed with the submission we had. I won't support the motion, not because I don't understand or support the angst and would want a decision. I just don't like the date.
My comment briefly, totally opposed to this amendment, don't support it at all.
Councillor Rose.
I think it's right that we should speak. I understand the feeling behind the mover and the seconder's proposition, Mr. Chairman. I understand it quite clearly, and I do have some sympathy for it. However, I too am not happy with the date. I feel that if the negotiations are perhaps are as intense as were indicated to us, and indeed if he's presenting it to us at the September meeting as indicated, you know, we might be a little bit tight on the 30th of September. So on that basis, I will vote against the amendment.
If I could speak, the indications that I've picked up are they would be ready by the end of September. I don't think that's the issue, but I understand the intention of the resolution and appreciate the debate. Let's see how the pennies fall. Any other speakers wish to sum up?
Well, just briefly, Mr. Chair, the point of putting a date on this is to focus the minds that the council wants a resolution of this. And it's not like those other projects. There were very clear guidelines given, and they simply have not been complied with. And that to me, is the bottom line here, that this is a great opportunity. It was promised on numerous occasions to be delivered on in September and November and then January, and it simply didn't transact. My concern is if you leave this in the ether going forward, we'll be having the same debate next year and without the go-forward that's needed. So I'm just suggesting to you, by putting a date around it, it might be incentive for those parties to get around the table and sort something out. Otherwise, it's use it or lose it.
Put that motion in. All those in favour, please say aye. Contrary, no. Carried. Needs to be a show of hands. All those in favour. Sorry, I missed you, Councillor McGregor. Against? Carried.
I believe, Mr. Chairman, could I just seek your indulgence briefly for a matter concerning the webcasting? Yesterday, Councillor Dick had a bit of an oops, but we'll soon learn that we're under surveillance. But there could be an occasion here where a visitor comes in here, could be a staff member or a visitor, and either forgets, or someone making a presentation either forgets that we've been filmed or doesn't know, and it could have serious consequences. There'll be no press here, no one in the gallery. Well, it's a public meeting, but we'll say something that they otherwise wouldn't want to become public, and I believe it's ethical that when you're being recorded, everyone knows about it, and I believe that there should be a clear sign at the door of this council chamber to say that recording's taking place.
Very good point, Councillor McGregor.